once my grandfather passed away, it became apparent that I had not taken advantage of anything while he was alive. I heard bits and pieces and stories of while I was a kid, but once I was grown up and I wanted to put those bits and pieces together as a puzzle, there was nowhere to find the information. Everybody would have a different version of events. It was very time consuming. A lot of records on the internet weren't on the internet from back in those days. I wanted to know about his Purple Heart. I wanted to know about the war stories. I wanted to know about when he had started the homicide division for the police force in Pittsburgh.
Since my stepfather has died, looking back, all I can see that I have photos of him. I wish I knew a lot more about him, what he did as a kid, what he grew up, where he worked. Just a lot of questions. I wish I had more information on him. I wish I had a way to find out more about him.
When I decided to do the documentary of my father, I remember I was looking through the photos and things of that nature, and I realized that we really didn't have any footage of Dad talking. I mean, it was always about a birthday or a Christmas party or something like that, and it was just quick flashes. And, you know, we kind of knew that we needed to document his life. I mean, the grandkids, they'd need to know what he was doing, you know, what he had done his whole life.
When I was 7 years old, my mother took me to a daycare center. We laid down on the mat, and I can remember getting cookies at lunchtime. And when she picked me up, she would take me to her drugstore. She was a soda jerk back then. That's what they called it behind the counter. And she would make me either a chocolate shake or a cherry shake. Those are the things that I remember back then. When I was living in Fort Lauderdale, they would come by after school and we would either play marbles outside, out in the front, or either we'd talk about girls. And there was a neighbor across the street that had a Cushman Eagle, and that was an old type of scooter that he would deliver papers on, and I would help him fold papers and throw them on the back of the scooter and deliver them around the houses and things like that. And we collected coins and we collected marbles and baseball cards and ride bikes. That's what we'd do when we were younger. What was it like growing up in the 50s and 60s? We didn't have to lock our doors. We could leave the keys in the car. Didn't have to worry about anybody robbing us. It was a simple life. It was a joyous life. And our biggest thing was when I got to go out, sometimes when I went on dates, my dad let me use the car when I was of age, and I had to take my sisters with me on my dates because he couldn't trust me with the women, I guess, or when I go to a drive-in. I had all the five sisters and two brothers in the back of the station wagon while me and the girl would sit up front and watch the movie. So they, really, there was no naked going on.
Did you have trouble explaining that to your girlfriends?
I didn't have many dates after that. I would get one date with them, and I would explain to them that that was a situation, and I didn't know why Dad would do that, but now, as I look back, I can understand.
Sitting on an ivy tree,